Gunman opens fire on congressional baseball practice. A gun-wielding man with a deep hatred of President Trump opened fire on GOP lawmakers at a baseball field on Wednesday, critically injuring the House Majority Whip. The shooter fired from behind the fence of the Eugene Simpson Stadium Park near the third dugout as Louisiana Representative Steve Scalise was on second base. Multiple people ran for cover in the first base dugout. The gunman is believed to have used an SKS rifle and a 9mm pistol, firing at least 50 rounds during the attack. Scalise was hit with a single rifle shot to the left hip, which fractured his bones and damaged his internal organs. He reportedly dragged himself 15 yards to the outfield and lay there until the shooting ended. He was rushed to the hospital and is still in critical condition. The gunman was killed following a shootout with police. Four others have been reported injured, including a congressional staffer, a lobbyist, and two Capitol Police officers. Authorities have identified the deceased suspect as 66-year-old Illinois resident James Hodgkinson. Described as a Bernie Sanders supporter and angry over the election of President Donald Trump, Hodgkinson had for weeks been spotted sitting at the nearby YMCA, which had a clear view of the baseball field. Say no to safe spaces on YouTube. Support Tomo News at patreon.com/tomonews. Not everyone is a fan of the Donald. Canadian immigration website crashes as Trump is elected U.S. president. As the scales tipped in favor of Donald Trump last night, many Americans started to consider possible exit strategies. The friendliest alternative reality? Well, Canada, of course. Guess everyone had the same idea at the same time because Canada's immigration website literally crashed. Everything's fine now, but if you're looking to escape to the Great White North, there are a few things you can do to get there. One thing you can do is enroll in a college or university in Canada. You can stay on a student visa and try to find work after you graduate. If you're already past the schooling stage of your life, applying for a job under the North American Free Trade Agreement may be your ticket to entry. Or maybe consider investing in a seasonal home. Foreign ownership won't get you a visa, but Americans are allowed to visit Canada for up to 6 months at a time. And if all those avenues don't work for you, try meeting a nice Canadian and get hitched. Once married, your new partner can sponsor you for immigration. Granted, all those options come with their own sets of strings and hurdles, and unfortunately, fear of Trump isn't enough to achieve political refugee status for asylum. Sorry! That being said, if thoughts of moving to Canada offer a beacon of light in the darkness of an impending nightmare, then dream on, America. Dream on. Trump fans walk out after Amy Schumer disses the Donald. Comedian Amy Schumer successfully pissed off more than 200 Trump supporters after she roasted the Donald at her Tampa comedy show. Schumer's performance on Sunday started out with her standard lineup of raunchy sex jokes about herself. But talk turned political when the comic pulled the Trump card, referencing the Republican candidate's recent p-grabbing remark. At one point, she invited a pro-Trump fella to come up and explain his choice. The full video on our website shows the guy's response and how it didn't sit well with Schumer. The audience member was promptly dismissed, and the Trump fans who hadn't been booing before certainly were now. Around 200 walked out as Schumer continued to diss the orange, sexual assaulting, fake college-starting monster who wanted to finger his daughter. She directed security to chuck out any hecklers and proceeded to fangirl over Hillary to the rest of the 8,400 people who cared. A bunch of netizens took to social media to give Schumer flack about mocking Trump, but the comedian seemed unfazed. She's performing at Madison Square Garden on Tuesday, where she may or may not dole out more anti-Trump Schumerisms. Fingers crossed! UK teen wanted to kill Donald Trump using a police officer's handgun. An autistic British man living in the US illegally reportedly traveled to Las Vegas last weekend with the intent to kill Donald Trump. Police say suspect Michael Sanford spoke with an officer at a Las Vegas Donald Trump rally on Saturday about getting an autograph, but then tried to take the officer's weapon. The 19-year-old was eventually subdued by officers and then handed over to the United States Secret Service. Sanford allegedly said he wanted to kill Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump. He reportedly wanted to shoot him using the officer's gun. The British team reportedly practiced firing 20 rounds of a Glock pistol at a shooting range before driving to Las Vegas and had been planning to kill Trump for a year. Authorities say Sanford has been living out of his car with an expired U.S. visa and that he suffers from a form of autism. A U.S. judge found Sanford a danger to the community and a flight risk at a court hearing on Monday. The suspect remains in custody and further charges are pending. Say no to safe spaces on YouTube. Support Tomo News at patreon.com/TomoNews. Trump's Mexican border wall just got another 10 feet taller. That was Donald Trump's papier-mâché head blowing up in Mexico on Saturday, after dozens of towns on the south side of the future Great Wall of Trump decided the popular businessman would be a good stand-in for Judas at the annual Judas Festival held just before Easter. The tradition symbolizes Christ's victory over evil, but also provides a nice excuse to blow shit up. An Obama effigy and paper ISIS fighter were also set alight, but the crowd seemed happiest at Trump's incineration, as they reportedly enthusiastically chanted death as the Trump doll exploded. We imagine the bombastic billionaire may have replied with something like this.
I love the Mexican people.
The wall just got 10 feet taller.
And comparing Trump to Judas is a bit unfair. As we all know, Trump would have gotten a much better deal for selling out Christ than just 30 pieces of silver.
Well, I mean, you don't have to be a total genius to figure this out, even though I am a genius, okay? You know, deals, I've been a great deal guy. The only thing I don't do so well is not everybody loves me. I don't know. And I'm actually a nice person.
The wall just got 10 feet taller.
Looks like President Trump's first overseas visit will probably not be to Mexico. YouTube and advertisers boycott Trump-related news. YouTube and YouTube advertisers don't seem to like Donald Trump. At Tomo News, we've noticed a pattern. Any video mentioning Donald Trump, no matter how innocuous, doesn't get advertising. Take, for example, this animation on Donald Trump's presidential limo, which has generated more than 800,000 views. Who would be offended by that? YouTube and advertisers, apparently. This video earned us a healthy revenue stream from advertising. But then Donald Trump announced his controversial executive order banning travel from 7 Muslim countries, and advertising revenue plummeted. YouTube has completely demonetized the video. We checked other videos featuring Donald Trump and noticed a similar pattern. This video about the hair loss drug Propecia earns just 10% of what a normal video would get because the word Trump appears in the video's headline and metadata. And it doesn't matter if your video is for or against Trump. Just mention his name and YouTube punishes you by not giving you advertising. YouTube maintains a list of negative keywords. If you mention ISIS in your headline or metadata, you won't get advertising. YouTube apparently thinks Donald Trump is as bad as ISIS. It's no secret that Google has joined other Silicon Valley companies in opposing Trump's immigration ban. But we never thought Google would enact an advertising boycott on Trump-related news. That's bad for everyone.